Hey there, it's Kaylee. We're gonna learn how to test solutions to inequalities. Make sure you remember how inequalities work before we start this lesson. Let's go. So here we have a basic inequality. It says x is greater than 5. And we have a list of possible solutions here. Solutions are different values for the variable x that will make the inequality true. We can test these solutions by using substitution. And we already know how to do that. Wherever we see it be x, we can plug in the possible solutions and check if the statement is true. So let's go ahead and try it. So our first possible solution says x equals 3, and I'm going to plug 3 into my original inequality here. So I'll have 3 is greater than 5. Is that a true statement? No. 3 is actually less than 5, so that means x equals 3 is not a possible solution here. Let's try the next one. So here we'll just substitute our 7 in for x, and we'll have 7 is greater than 5. Is that a true inequality? Yeah, that is true. 7 is greater than 5. So that means when x equals 7, we do have a solution. And now for our last one here, we have x is equal to 13. So we'll substitute 13 in, and we get 13 is greater than 5. Is that a true statement? Yes, 13 is greater than 5. So that means x equals 13 is a solution. Wait a minute. How many solutions did we just find? Yeah, 2. So this is something really special about inequalities. They can have more than one solution. In fact, they can have an infinite or never-ending number of solutions. Pretty amazing, right? This one says, find the values of y that make both inequalities true. And we have 2 inequalities. Y is less than 23. And y is greater than 6. And we have a list of possible solutions. Now we need to test each solutions in both inequalities and find the solutions that will make both inequalities true. And we can still use substitution. So let's start with our first one, y equals 18. I'm going to try it in this one first. So I'll substitute 18 in for y, and I'll have 18 is less than 23. Is that true? Yes, 18 is less than 23. Now let's try it over here. 18 is greater than 6. Is that true? Yes. So it's true over here and it's true over here. So that means y equals 18 is a solution for both inequalities. Now let's try y equals 4. Is 4 less than 23? Yep, that's true. How about over here? Is 4 greater than 6? I don't think so. 4 is less than 6. So this is not a solution for this inequality. And since we're looking for solutions to both inequalities, that means y equals 4 does not count as a solution here. Last one, we're testing y equals 26. Is 26 less than 23? No, that's not true. So already, if we know it's not a solution here, we know that y equals 26 isn't a solution to both if it's not a solution to the first one. So we already know it's not, but we can test it just to be sure. Is 26 greater than 6? Yeah, that is true. But if the solution's only true for one, we still can't count y equals 26 as a possible solution. So which of these is a possible solution for both of our inequalities? That's right, just y equals 18. Good job. Okay, last example here is a bit more complex. We have an inequality that says 3x plus 4 is less than or equal to 4x. And we have possible solutions that we need to test. Now, how should we go about this? Yeah, the same way we've been doing it. Even though we have a complicated inequality, we can still use substitution. So let's plug in these values and see which one makes our inequality true. First one, we have x equals 3. So same thing, I'm going to plug in my 3 here and my 3 here. So I'll have 3 times 3 plus 4 is less than or equal to 4 times 3. Now I can use order of operations. I'll have 9 plus 4 is less than or equal to 12. Now I can do my addition. 9 plus 4, 13 is less than or equal to 12. Is that true? No, right? 13 is bigger than 12. So this is not a possible solution. Next one, x equals 4. Same thing, I'm going to use substitution. I have 3 times 4 plus 4 is less than or equal to 4 times 4. Order of operations, multiplication comes first. I get 12 plus 4 is less than or equal to 16. Now I can go ahead and add, and I get 16 is less than or equal to 16. Is this true? Yeah, right? Because we have our or equal to sign here, and 16 is equal to 16. So that's true. And that makes x equal 4 a solution. Last one here, we're testing x is equal to 5. So I have 3 times 5 plus 4 is less than or equal to 4 times 5. I do my multiplication first. I have 15 plus 4 is less than or equal to 20. I go ahead and do my addition. I get 19 is less than or equal to 20. Is that true? Yeah, 19 is less than 20. So that is true. And I'll put my check mark over here. X equals 5 is a possible solution. So how many solutions did we find here? Yeah, we found 2 solutions or 2 values of x that make our inequality true. Does that mean there are only 2 solutions to this inequality? No, it actually doesn't. It just means that out of the 3 possible solutions that we decided to test, 2 of them make our inequality true. But there are actually many, many more. If you want, you can keep trying more numbers to see if you can find any other solutions. Now that you know how to test solutions to inequalities, it's time for you to do some practice on your own. Have fun and remember to always be clever.